Hello friends, welcome back to Snowflake tutorial. In this video, we are going to discuss about stages and its types on Snowflake. In Snowflake, there is a critical part of database is storage of the data. Snowflake is capable of both accessibility like store the data within the environment and accessing it in other cloud storage environments. Whether it is stored internally or externally, the location and the data is stored in a stage. And the process of uploading files into one of these stages is known as staging. Snowflake have two types of stages. First, internal. In internal, there is a three categories available: user stages, table stages, and named stages. And another one stage is external. In external, everything will be followed with cloud environment. So you can create your stages on top of AWS, Azure, and GCP. Let me see some examples and hands-on in this video. Let me start with internal stages. First, we can take user stages. User stages given by Snowflake team. Whenever user created, the stage will create for their own purpose. We cannot drop or delete anything. User stages we can view via @ and delta symbol. So list @ delta, then it will be showing that all the stages of user details. Table stages also like user stages. Whenever the table was created, and this table stage will create for each table. And it was given by Snowflake team. So we cannot drop or delete anything in this. If you want to retrieve the table stages, you can use @ and percentage symbol and then table name. Here is an example: list @ percentage and table name. So this is the table stage for patient internal. If suppose you are going to execute, that is no data, so it is showing as empty. Using put command, I am directly insert into this table stages, and then I am trying to see now the data is reflect. Next, named stages. This stages only you can create, drop, and perform all other operations. Now I'm create a stage named as my internal stage, and I declare the file format as CSV and delimiter as comma and header as true. Once I execute the command, the stage will create and I can see via show stages. Here the stage name will reflect and it will be showing as type of internal. Next, we are going to create an external stages. External stage also look like named stages. In external stages, we must declare URL name. Here, I'm going to create an external stages. Name is called snow stage. I declare the URL with the AWS environment and I pass the credential to access and read only. Once I execute it, stage will create and I can use it. Once we create the stages, we can see the properties using show commands. So show stages, once I execute this command, I can see the created stage details and its types. Here snow stage is a table name we have created and it is external with cloud AWS. So this information we can collect it from this stage properties. Now we can see what are the data is available on external stages. Using list command, I can retrieve the data and it is showing S3 bucket, what are the data will be stored. And I just located only for CSV. In CSV, user.csv file will be stored. And we can see with the size of the data and all. Now I am trying to copy the data from the stage into table hello user. Once I executed, the data will be stored into the hello user table and status has loaded and number of rows as 12,435 records. Like that, you can use external stages for your Snowflake table environment. Thank you for watching this video. Please share your valuable feedback and interest topics in the comment below. We will work out and make a video as you advised.